destination and destination. And there it is. It just finally showed up. So that is so cool. Thank you, Jay Snap, 1982. Everyone give him a big round of applause, because look at the banner up top. That is automatic. That's automatic. So that, how cool is that? All right. That's pretty cool. All right. So we'll, I'm really excited about that. So it says PA 31 departing, John Wayne heading to, Palomar. That's just cool. We'll tune over to, turn over to, John Wayne Clarence. Hello, Zacho Gaming on Twitch. Good to see you. We'll get flight following on our... I just have to remember how to ask for flight following. Last night, I forgot to ask for flight following. Some of you caught that stream. Hello, Ham I Am. And by the way, you should correct people when they call you Hamium, because you're Ham I Am. you're in Utah right now. What are you doing in Utah? Oh, someone just flying right over the field. Someone took off. I wonder if that's a drone or a real pilot. Anyway, don't get distracted. Squirrel. All right, let's go down into the cockpit. Inside. Ground is on 120.8 on this side. By the way, this is GPB 500 scenery for John Wayne. Pretty cool stuff. All right. I will minimize for flight way down, so you can see. You can see this cockpit. Have to resync my switch panel here. And let's, during this procedure, I'm going to go ahead and turn on some. Turn on some sounds. Batteries. I don't see a beacon light on this one. So, fuel pump on. We'll come down here and we'll go full mixture, prop full, set our parking brake. We'll crack the throttle. Take our start button. Doesn't that sound good? That is a good sounding engine. We'll turn on some avionics. Go ahead and slip on our noise canceling headset. Yeah, that looks good. I love that. We're not starting each engine by itself. We're just going with the side tech panel down here and just going, bam, rocking it. I know. Tiny bit too raspy. Side effect, too much fun. Yeah, I am sounding a little raspy. Yeah, I just want to, I'm on a limited time schedule today, so I had to start both engines, right? Okay, we don't need weather radar. What I want to know is, check. For some reason, PE's not coming in. So I need to come up here. Yeah, it's there. 118. John Wayne Clarence. Piper 572 Kilo Juliet, radio check.
We're 572 Kilo Juliet, John Wayne Clarence, VD 11 clear.
Thank you. Let's get the ATIS. Well, we don't need the ATIS quite yet, but. Oh, do I need to be on Discord? I'll go on Discord in the cruise probably. All right. JAWing clearance, Piper 572 Kilo Juliet, VFR departure to the north, request flight following at 7,500.
Number 572 Kilo Juliet, JAWing clearance, say destination.
We're doing a tour of the real estate over toward Hemet Ryan, French Valley, and then destination Palomar, 572 Kilo Juliet.
572 Kilo Juliet, Roger, on departure, fly heading 080, maintain VFR at or below 3,000. Departure frequency 128.1, squawk 4273.
Okay, after departure, fly heading 080 will maintain VFR at or below 3,000, 128.1, squawk 4273, 572 Kilo Juliet.
572 Kilo Juliet, read back, correct.
Okay, so we'll put in the squawk code of 4273 down here. I'll give you guys, since you may have not seen this aircraft before, 4273, and I probably should have said VFR departure to the east, but I think he got the idea once I gave him my path. Okay, so we've now squawking altitude. Yeah, in fact, I may just throw up a multi-twitch here, PG. I think that's how it would work. Yeah, Robin strikes out on his
Delta
own.
Delta 144 audio check.
Delta 144, San Francisco clearance, VD loud and clear.
And clearance Delta 144 when you get a sec, IFR to Los Angeles, please.
Okay, so, so there's the multi-twitch link I just posted in the chat.
144, clear to Los Angeles, last loop for ESTIC 3 departure, eBay transition, then it's filed. Climb via SID, squawk 4365.
And I'm going to mute those, but I'm going to keep an eye on them.
All right, clear to Los Angeles, stick 3 departure, eBay transition, then it's filed. Climb via SID, squawk 4365.
All right, we'll turn over to ground 120.8. We'll put tower in 119.9. I want you guys to really enjoy this nice long taxi because this scenery by GPB 500 is amazing. We're going to go grab the ATIS. We're going to myflightroute.com. It's over here on this page, myflightroute.com. It's amazing. I'm clicking on the ATIS player, scrolling down to KSNA, and I'm going to, it's information uniform.
Wind 170 at 4. Visibility 10. Ceiling 1,500 overcast. Temperature to 1. 2.16. Altimeter 3004. ILS 20 right approach in use. Landing and departing runway 20 right 20 left. Departing runway 20 left. 20 right. Use caution for bird activity in the vicinity of the airport. Read back all runway assignments and hold short instructions. All VFR departures, contact clearance to...
Alright, so there's information uniform. Yeah, when I send out the Discord invites, they usually they expire within 24 hours, but once you're into the server, it should be permanent unless you get banned or something. Okay, so ground 120.8. Let's call them. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell them who I am, and I'm kind of being a little tutorial-like today because there's a few pilots that have reached out to me saying I've learned a lot. Can you talk about the basics? So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to say to John Wayne Ground who I am, where I am, and what I want to do. So in this case, I'm at Atlantic Aviation. I'm Piper 572 Kilo Juliet at Atlantic Aviation East Side. Request taxi with information uniform. Now notice that I'm not using the word taxi with taxi to the active, and I'm trying to cut down on words that I don't need to use. But you all know that I'm not the best all the time with that. Hello FSE Tony B, how you doing? All right, let's give him a call. I bet you the multi-twitch link looks pretty dang cool, actually. Okay. JAWing Ground, Piper 572 Kilo Juliet at Atlantic Aviation Southeast Side. Request taxi with uniform.
For 572 Kilo Juliet, JAWing Ground, way 20 left at Kilo, taxi via Alpha Hotel Charlie.
20 left at Kilo via Alpha Hotel Charlie, 572 Kilo Juliet. Good morning.
Good morning.
So we're going to just start our taxi. So we'll turn on our taxi light and show you guys this bird from the outside for a moment. Oh, this is a cool looking bird. I'll tell you right now. Ooh, brakes work.
And clearance Delta 144, my apologies. Can we amend
the taxi final light is on?
To level 250, please?
Delta 144 affirmative, but I mean, I expect 250 for the final.
So again, this is GPB 500 scenery. The textures are amazing. So just a little secret between you and me.
Charlie is Rebo inbound.
This is a...
runway 27.
74 Tarawin Tower, wind calm.
There's a certain phrase for this.
Runway 27, clear to land.
I'm sure the taxiway will do this. I'm going to do a slow taxi up here. Okay. All right, here we go. This is the words I'm going to do. Sorry, I'm texting really slow, but it's okay. Okay, there's an early release program by GPB 500. If you do a private message to GPB 500 on the X-Plane, X-Plane.org forums, a private message to him, he'll explain to you the early release program. And it's really cool. You can get, there's only a handful of people that have this particular scenery and many others that are in, it's a pre-release program which has some awesome scenery. So, yeah, exclamation GPB 500 gives you a link to get how to contact him. So, yeah, PMM, he'll give you the details on the early release program. All right, well, you can see a lot of it from inside the cockpit. Probably should lean a little bit for taxi. I mean, look at the details on the buildings. Static aircraft are cool. Signatures coming up here. Rob, you're coming right along, man. By the way, Rob, did you see what I did on M. Congrove's stream the other night? Okay, let me just... I'm so happy about this. Where is it? Where did I put it? The thing runs on a Kraken. All right. So so Rob, I'm on M. Congrove's stream. By the way, those of you who don't know about M. Congrove, maybe someone can post a link to his Twitch channel and give him a follow. He's developing LaGuardia 2020. So Rob, so what I did on his stream is I sent him this link, right? This is the new 2020 Salt Lake City, and they're basically going to have an upper and level, lower level. I mean, they're really completely redoing the terminal, big time.
Number tower, Charlie is clear at Charlie 6.
It's got all this new animation, and so M. Congrove, his eyes went large, and he started thinking. You know, you could see the wheels were turning. So, it appears as though I got him to put it on the list, and if I'm not mistaken, it got moved high on the list for Salt Lake City 2020, and it's amazing what you can do, how you can influence the world through a little bit of Twitch stream chat. and dropping a few links. Oh, good, Rob. That's awesome. I'm glad he sent that to you. An Airplane Man 321. And Lubal, hello. Airplane Man 321, this is your first stream. Well, welcome. Welcome aboard. I'm glad, very glad to have you. There's a lot of great streamers in here. If you click on the title above, it says Globe. John Fly is streaming. Da 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 da. At the end, it says Global Sim Alliance. You can click the follow button below, and that will you'll follow me, and you can get an email alert. Whether or not you want to follow me and get an email alert, it's totally up to you. But the Global Sim Alliance has a lot of great streamers on it. So anyway, I'm kind of excited about Salt Lake City. Possible partnership in the works too. Nice. Because you got a non-disclosure agreement, right? No, I'm enjoying. I'm really excited to. I'm really excited to fly into KBTL when it's done. Flash 23, how you doing, sir? So yeah, here's GPB 500. Oh, by the way, let me just point out something here. This thank you for the follow, M. And that over there, that's an MD-11. Let me give you a little inside information, right? That MD-11 has never ever been to John Wayne.
A tower six.
In fact, 346 here. Not one MD-11 has ever been to John Wayne.
Ontario Tower.
The largest aircraft that it has ever flown left to John Wayne is a 757. Now, there were some cargo Airbus A300s, but I think the A300 is smaller than the 757, or is it not? I don't know. But there's been nothing, the quote is, nothing bigger than a 757 has ever flown into John Wayne. So I believe the author of this scenery is going to take out the MD-11 and put something in that actually is realistic. And that's the kind of detail that this guy takes to his airports, is he wants it to be as realistic as possible. But that also means that those of us that fly the 777 or the Airbus A330 or the 767, that actually doesn't fly out of John Wayne, according to what I was told. So, interesting. Yeah, that route is not updated. The subsonic flight, look above, it says, got a new banner up atop there that JSNAP 1982 put together. And so it shows the route is KSNA to KCRQ, but we're not doing an IFR flight. Otherwise, the IFR, oh, he put it in there. Oh, that's cool. So Peter updated the route. Even though I'm a VFR departure, he put in there Hemet Ryan and French Valley and then Palomar. Oh, cool. And it also up there shows the aircraft. And that's all happening automatically, courtesy of JSNAP's wizardry. And anyone that is on the Global Sim Alliance is welcome to coordinate with JSNAP for a similar overlay onto your stream. Got to make sure that we are going to the right location. In my humble opinion, smaller the Airbus is. Where do you get this scenery? Yeah, scenery, if you type in Airplane Man 321, if you type in exclamation GPB, that's Golf Papa Bravo, exclamation GPB, that's the gentleman that makes this scenery, but it's under an early release program, kind of a sneak preview program. PM for the details on how to get it, but you can download his other aircraft. Thank you, Rob, for the post. My brother was watching your stream, and he made me make my set like yours. Oh, nice. Well, hello to you and your brother. Yesterday I saw a Mango Cargo Airbus and a FedEx 757. Think the 757 was larger. Okay. Yeah, so according to my sources, nothing larger than a 757 has ever flown into here. I'm going to turn off my taxi light, turn on my nav and my strobes. I'm going to tune over to tower 119.9. I'm going to go ahead and put in my initial altitude. We got to stay below 3,000 for now until they let us go unrestricted. So we'll take this down to 3,000. And then on our heading after departure, we're supposed to fly heading 080. And our departure frequency is 128.1. I think that's correct. So I think we can call them now. Are you guys ready? I'm ready. I think I'm ready. So I may be a little not paying attention to chat for a moment here during the departure, so forgive me for that. Oh, it's your home airport. Nothing bigger than the 757. Cool. Jumpfly, the banner is being cut off on the right side, it seems. Maybe need to work the web view on wider in OBS.
612 Sierra okay. Romeo, Long Beach clearance.
Good Let's do that right now.
Vicente Inez Airport. Fly runway heading for reaching 800 feet, then turn left heading 270. Radar vector CLB to VOR that is filed. Maintain 3,000, expect 8,000, 1 minute after departure. Departure frequency 128.1, squawk 2571.
No, that didn't work. Hold on.
Sierra 612 Sierra Romeo, clear to Sandy Inez Airport, fly runway heading to 800 feet, then left turn 270, radar vector Seal Beach, then as filed. Expect 3,000, or actually 3,000, expect 8,000 and 10. Departure 128.1, squawk 2571.
For 612 Sierra Romeo, read that correct. For 572 Kilo Juliet, verify squawking 4273.
Okay, how now? 4273, 572 Kilo Juliet.
Number 2 Kilo Juliet, I got you good now. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, I think that's a little better with the overlay. Okay. All right, yeah, I think our mouse accidentally went one digit too long. John Wayne Tower, 572 Kilo Juliet, holding short 20 left at Kilo. John Wayne Tower, that is.
572 Kilo Juliet, John Wayne Tower, runway 20 left at Kilo, clear for takeoff.
20 left at Kilo, clear for takeoff, 572 Kilo Juliet. Okay, so we're going to taxi into position here. I think that looks better there. Is that given the heading also? All right, so look at the texture of the runway here. Woo, GG. Didn't go through my checklist. Hope my trim is okay. All right, so we're going to do...
Ontario ground, November 346, Sierra Papa's. Clearly active at Foxtrot.
Sorry that we got all have our noise-canceling headsets on today. Can't hear much of the engine.
346 Sierra Papa Roger, and where are you parking?
We're doing a no flaps takeoff here.
346 Sierra Papa Roger, taxi to parking via Foxtrot. Let's go gear up. Cross runway 26 left. G'day.
Foxtrot and Sierra cross 266 Sierra Papa. Thanks.
Woo. Okay, so now we're gonna depart and we're gonna turn left heading. Over to 080. He's probably going to hand us off pretty soon. Okay, so we got to. I'm hand flying. I'm not on autopilot yet. I got to stay below 3,000. And boy, this bird flies.
For 572 Kilo Juliet, radar contact, contact departure.
Contact departure, 572 Kilo Juliet. Good day. All right, so there's our 080 heading. And we'll... SoCal departure, 572 Kilo Juliet, 1,500 climbing 3,000.
Piper 572 Kilo Juliet, SoCal departure, cancel out two restrict runs of mode navigation and traffic numerous targets in vicinity of El Toro Airport.
Okay, cancel altitude restriction, resume on nav, we'll look for traffic, 572 Kilo Juliet. All right, so there we have it. So let's trim up the aircraft a little bit here because it's wanting to pitch high. I can resume my own nav. Let's go ahead and sync the heading bug. And you have two different ways of doing this. You can come down here and hit the autopilot, or you don't have to look down, and you can cheat and go autopilot, and you can go heading mode. And then you can go altitude, and then I can start manipulating my SciTech panel. So we're going to go, we'll go up here. That looks good. So there we go. There's the Piper Navajo taking off out of John Wayne. I haven't figured out how to. I haven't figured out where the altitude setting is in this plane. So if anyone happens to see it before I do, I can't see where in here I can set my altitude, other than I'm rotating the dial on my SciTech panel up to our cruise altitude. I'm going to bring back the engine just a little bit so we're a little more kind on the engine. But as you can see, we're going 180 knots, which is kind of cool. Climbing out at 700 feet. And here's the ortho that everyone wanted to see. Hope my trim is okay. Immediate nosedive into the bushes. Is it twitchy? Yes. Thank you for editing the route there. Or did it edit? Maybe a different command. All right, so, yeah. I love how Ortho 4 XP does the water borders. It's awesome. We got traffic. We got cars. There we go. We finally got up to 7,500 on our SciTech panel. We're just doing a leisurely cruise up to 7,500. We're just doing 700 feet per minute.
Don't mean to alarm anybody, but I think...
734 Tango Delta radar contact lost.
And Boom Ruler, thank you for the follow. Let's turn the sounds up just a little bit so we can hear that flyby. Should we do one more just for grins? Yeah, I'm not so sure that we need the. Ooh, that's loud, huh? I'm not so sure that we need the route, but there is a BrainBot command, but it's up at the top, right? So permanently, always up at the top. Did you make these by yourself? No, I didn't. JSNAP 1982 has created this ortho. So he's the man. He's here in chat. Thank you, JSNAP, for some amazing work. I was running G2XPL before, switched over to ortho, and yeah, it looks pretty good. I wasn't logged into my Discord for it. Save it. Could find it once I logged in. Okay. Oh, we better make sure that we clear this. So we'll increase our feet per minute because we're coming up to 5,000. All right, we're almost to cruise, so I can probably turn on the Discord.
I don't mean to alarm anybody, but I think we're being followed.
Edwin Joshi, thank you for the follow. I really appreciate that. All right, so Discord is now open. Let's go here. I'm in the. Test one. Yep, I'm on Vox. You hear me okay, Rob? If anyone wants to join the Discord, I will go ahead and copy here. So there, run the Discord app, or the app is the best way to do it, but the website will also get you there. So click on that, sign up on Discord, and you can join my Discord. And there's forums and chat and live chat and voice chat and all that good stuff. So.
Oh. Yeah, I didn't have my mic on. I got you loud and clear.
Hey, Rob, good morning. Or good afternoon for you, I guess.
Yep.
Yeah, JSNAP's done me a nice one here, hasn't he?
Oh yeah, I love ortho. Oh.
Mm-hmm. Everyone, this is Rob KBTL. Tell them what airport you're working on, scenery development-wise.
I guess the name kind of gives it away. I'm working on KBTL, which is Battle Creek, Michigan. Kind of a small little Class D. I say small, but it has like the third largest runway in the state of Michigan, but still kind of small.
Looking forward to the... I'm on your beta team, aren't I?
Of course.
Good, good.
Even though we're nowhere near a beta.
Well, one day. Looks like the Piper Navajo is leveling off at 7,500. Yeah, so what JSNAP is saying there is, so before I was running G2XPL and my Zoom level, I did Zoom level 17, and for seven, eight months, I just did Zoom level 17 G2XPL. I tiled the entire U.S. from the West Coast, top to bottom, all the way over to Atlanta, top to bottom. And then I've pretty much gotten rid of all of it. All that work, because I've switched to Ortho 4XP. And the interesting part about it all is I don't mind all that work because I got to fly it while I was tiling, you know. I got to fly over a lot of the tiles. And I learned a lot, and it was fun. It was a little bit much on the electric bill, but that's okay. Okay, so we're going to turn north a little bit. Oh, you know what we forgot to do? How many of you run FS Economy? What did I forget to do?
Did you not start it?
Yep, didn't start it. Got too excited about the plane. Got too excited about the scenery. I did not load my passengers. Passengers are on the tarmac down at Atlantic and going, where the hell's our Piper? Got too excited.
Well, you're not burning your fuel. You can always turn back and get them.
That's true. Just do a low pass. Drop a rope. FSE noob. That's right. I'm also a noob. Apparently, Rob, I cannot have maker's mark and do a proper call to ground or clearance. So last night at Brown KSDM, I'm doing a group flight with AeroSim Gaming. He's Batman 375, which is an official call sign for an airline. I'm Robin 572, so we're Batman and Robin. We also had Joker and Penguin on the network flying from Brown up to Henderson, Nevada, right? So they on the Brown.
Ooh,
I got a skirt. Oh, I'm going to violate the Charlie if I don't turn here. Oh, snap.
Source 2 Sierra Romeo, contact SoCal Approach 134.9er.
Almost violated the Charlie.
134.9er, 612.
No, I didn't. The Charlie ceiling's at 55. Whoo! All right, anyway. So on the Brown airport chart, there is a clearance delivery frequency, right? A clearance delivery frequency. So here I am thinking, okay, I need to call clearance. I need to get a VFR clearance. Well, I forgot to ask for flight following. So I called, I said, Brown clearance, Robin 572, VFR departure to the north. And he came back and said, I don't have a flight plan for you. And I said, I know, I'm flying VFR. Well, you don't need to talk to me if you're flying VFR, unless you need flight following. I said, well, I need flight following. A little maker's mark in there. Anyway, long story short, I learned that even though there's a clearance frequency listed, you don't need to get a VFR clearance. And it's really redundant that just so happens that the clearance frequency and the ground frequency are the same exact freaking frequency. It was superhero night on PE last night. I felt like I felt like a PE noob. But the maker's mark is partly to blame. But it was fun having Batman, Robin, Penguin, Joker. And get this. So AeroSim Gaming was in the Mitsubishi MU2.
Or 2 Kilo Juliet, contact SoCal Approach 135.4.
135.4, 2 Kilo Juliet. SoCal Approach 572 Kilo Juliet, level 7,500.
Parker 572 Kilo Juliet, SoCal Approach, Ontario Altimeter 2997. What's your destination?
907. Ultimately, it will be Palomar, but we're going via Hemet Ryan and French Valley. Should be in the system.
2 Kilo Juliet.
All right, so so we'll turn just a little bit north up here. So yeah, all those were legitimate call signs. It was a lot of fun. But here's the kicker though, is he's in the Mitsubishi MU2. I'm in the Piper PA-31. I took off just before him. He took off just a little bit after me. He was flying IFR. I was flying VFR. And he overtook me at one point. And then I ended up beating him to the runway in Henderson. So this plane was doing 240 knots across the ground. How awesome is that?
Yeah, I might have to pick this thing up.
Yeah, it's really good. And it works with SciTech panels. All right, so anyway, my ignoring chat here. Yeah, chemo, I am definitely a noob.
0612 Sierra Romeo, SoCal Approach, altimeter 2996.
J-Snap's going to release the code. He needs to clean it up a little bit, but definitely will. He's a master, Rob. You have no idea. I have a first-hand view of what he's doing, because he's doing it on my computer and on his. It's pretty cool stuff.
Yeah, that code that he's got there sounds like something I've been wanting for a long time with Ortho.
Well, I mean, it's so automatic, right? It's like so automatic. It's doing multiple tiles at once, and it's keeping track of the finish tiles. It's moving the finish tiles. It's baking the OSM. It's got the overlays. It's just brilliant. And then I can run a command, and it shows me the map of what tiles are done, so I can copy them from the tiling computer over to the SIM computer.
5 Kilo Juliet traffic, 9 o'clock, 1 mile southbound altitude, in case 6,500.
We have the traffic in sight. 2 Kilo Juliet. So yeah, it's amazing. I mean, with a G2 XPL, I was having to manually start each tile. So the automation is really pretty cool. But we have a blister. We have what we call a problem child tile, or a blister. And J-Snap, maybe you have an update on that. Or we're trying to get people to help out, because this one problem tile is creating a problem for all the tiles surrounding it. So it's up in Oregon, I think. All right, I need to turn a little bit more south here. We'll fly over French Valley and then down to Palomar. I did get Austin fixed. It was a bad G2 XPL tile, actually, that was crashing Austin.
144, Roger. Climb V said.
So, got that all fixed. Anyway, got a good group in here, about 40 of you here. It looks like about 11 of you are not following. Please consider clicking the follow button. We do giveaways. If you're a follower of John Fly, you get John Fly miles, and we do giveaways for. I did a giveaway just the other day of a DVD, Just Planes DVD 737-200, and consider clicking the follow button. As someone just did. Jay Green, 821. Thank you for the follow. Appreciate that. We also do giveaways for gift certificates. I was calculating the other day that we've given $900 worth of gift certificates. So, probably got to lay it back on that. But we've had a lot of donations in the stream. One thing I did notice here, though, is the follows are not showing up on the Twitch or the recent events.
But I think we're being followed.
T-Bird 18 Viper, thank you very much for the follow. You are now earning John Fly Miles. Same with you, J Green 821. Both earning John Fly Miles now. So that, yeah, the blister. Let me click on that link. What do we got there? Yep, that's the blister. That's the only issue at this point. We'll figure it out, though. That is the blister. I have nightmares about the blister. John Fly Miles are a program, a frequent flyer program, that allow you to auction on giveaways and also do roulette. And get more and bet on landings, and yeah, it's just for prizes and for prestige.
But I think
it's like a frequent diner program, but it's for watching the stream. All right, let's look at the is it the R Jamie 721? Thank you for the follow. Stream labels, no event list. Is it event list? Yeah, it's event.
Okay,
list.
So you want me to keep it? Okay.
Keep what?
Hold on, can you speak for a second?
That's 14, I don't expect our number, only 2-7 approach, thanks for weather.
Okay, I couldn't hear you. I was trying to differentiate from hearing you from Twitch and then the Discord, I couldn't even hear you. Now I can.
Piper 2 Kilo Juliet, contact SoCal approach, 119.6.
119.6, 2 Kilo Juliet. Yeah, Zacho, you're on Vox, by the way. SoCal approach 572 Kilo Juliet, level 7,500. We have the weather at Palomar and request visual approach.
Air 572 Kilo Juliet, SoCal approach Palomar, altimeter 29 or 96.
96, 2 Kilo Juliet.
144 contact Oakland Center 133.7.
All right, so now if we have one more person that can follow, I can test that follower. I'll just test it now. There we go. The follow is now working down below. That's cool. It's leaving the donations up there, but the follows scroll on and then scroll off. Okay, that's kind of cool.
144 Oakland Center, comment team 50250.
Max event is 4. Animation. 1 second.
Did the follower thing break?
No, that was just a test. It should be working. I'm just trying to figure out if the follow, if the follows stay up there permanently or they fade away. A test maybe just faded away, but I'm not sure.
Well, are you using Twitch alerts for your stuff?
For some things, yeah.
If you're using it for your followers, I know that the... I had this happen to me too. Testing... You test a follow and then appears up in the events bar. It only appears for a few seconds, whether the actual follow is by real people stays up permanently.
So, say that again. So, an actual follower does stay up permanently or doesn't?
The actual follower does stay up permanently, but the testing doesn't.
Oh, good. Good. Oh, here we go. Rob KBT Hill's following. I've heard of you, Rob.
I figured I've been watching for a while. I guess I could follow.
Sears 2 Sierra Romeo contact point McGrew approach 124.7.
Thanks for testing that, Rob.
0612 Sierra Romeo, pull me go approach, climb maintain 8000, altimeter 2995.
There's no way to adjust the volumes on the pilot edge receiver, is there?
I think you could do it if you ran it through some sort of virtual audio cable. I mean, you can do it in the control panel. If you're running the app, you could go to the volume mixer. But I thought you were talking about on stream.
Nah, I'd get the pilot edge receiver running so I can hear if ATC's calling you all in here. That way I don't walk over you. Thing is, it doesn't show up in my volume mixer, which is strange.
Oh, and you're running the app independently, right? Oh, that's weird.
Yep.
All right, so pattern altitude
is 4 Tango Delta, pick 10 o'clock, 2 miles, opposite direction, altitude in case 4,500, type in.
I have the traffic, but it's 4 Tango Delta.
Sounds like Kelly Pilot.
Yeah, that does heli. That's definitely heli pilot.
Who's heli pilot again?
Heli pilot 7. He's on the Global Sim Alliance. If you click the Global Sim Alliance above, you'll find heli pilot. And RomK BTO. All
right. Probably one of the.
I think I'm gonna need to descend here.
I think I've heard of him before.
360. Let me make a call here. Hold on. SoCal approach 572 Kilo Juliet. We're going to continue south to descend, and then we'll do a left 360 visual. We have the weather at Palomar. 572 Kilo Juliet.
2 Kilo Juliet, roger.
All right, so we're a little bit high, we're at 5,000 descending. We're going to do a left 360. And then do the visual approach at Palomar. Palomar Towers 118.6, so we'll get that ready. He'll hand us off. We're going to slow down a little bit.
But it's 4 Tango Delta.
Is that Navajo available for P3?
Approach, contact SoCal approach 124.35.
Yeah, Carinato, I think, makes it for FSX. 290,
but it's 4 Tango Delta.
FSX Guru 15, did you get my message on Twitch? I sent you a private message.
4736.
Check your private messages on Twitch.
Good morning. Cancel out 2 restrictions.
Maybe you
won't
navigate. Matt Davies just finished the stream at 21 hours. Man, that's a long haul.
Is it the PA-31 Chief's hang?
Mine's the PA-31 Navajo. I'm not sure if it's the Chieftain or not. Probably not.
CUFSC
Tony B. 734
Tango Delta SoCal approach, altimeter 299 radio, expect RNAV runway 27 approach.
Yeah, I don't see it on here.
Hey,
maybe
Cody,
it's only available for FSX.
You found it in the mixer, Rob? Okay, cool.
Yeah, I have my device set to my speakers, not my headphones. Duh.
Zacho, you just need to go to X-Plane, sir.
Parp 2 Kilo Juliet, traffic 3 o'clock, 1 mile, same direction, out to the case, 1,900, type it on.
Looking for traffic, 2 Kilo Juliet.
Parp 2 Kilo Juliet, just make that turn. He's now going to be at your 6 o'clock here in about a mile. Bananas 4 Tango Delta, traffic 12 o'clock, 1 mile opposite direction, altitude of case 4,500, type unknown. He's outside the Bravo.
Okay, it's Sidru. We want to be at 23. We're a little bit Okay, let's turn our landing light on. We want to go. Yeah, we're on. CDI is on LOC. We're at 2600.
Prop 2 Kilo Juliet, contact Palomar Tower 118.6.
Contact Tower 572 Kilo Juliet, see ya.
Prop 2 Kilo Juliet, squawk V.
Way 26 left at Whiskey.
And we'll squawk VFR 2 Kilo Juliet.
Juliet Bravo, Ontario Tower, and way 26 left there for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 26 left.
No. Why do they have me squawk VFR? Just manage my speed here. Oops, engine doesn't like that. And it's on. Palomar Tower 572 Kilo Juliet visual approach.
572 Kilo Juliet, Palomar Tower, runway 24, clear to land.
24, clear to land, 572 Kilo Juliet. Chieftain is a bit longer than the Navajo. So the Chieftain can have more than 8 people or no? Gear coming down. I love how the red light shows up here on the SciTec panel. Oh, it's pretty badass.
Never mind. The Navajo is on here. I didn't notice it.
Yeah, it's they typically make these models on P3D FSX first, and then they decide which ones I want to bring over to X-Plane. But if you want real flight dynamics, you come to X-Plane. Yeah, essentially, Guru, the email that I sent you is, I think it was Giant Unicorn that was scrubbing the data from IVAO from you. You were helping him with that. And if you see above, my banner above is pulling the data from Pilot Edge. So we're JSNAP. JSNAP 1982 is here in the chat.
3565 in contact departure.
And
okay, 3565. That was our fault. We'll contact
We want to
Juliet Bravo. Thank you.
Oh, cool. JSNAP. Look what Guru just said. It's an API link. FSX Guru, you're awesome. We ought to do shared cockpit soon. Okay, anyone know what the good landing speed is for this? They carry the same amount of passengers. Okay, FS Bart, how you doing?
Yeah, so like you said, there's no specific model for the Chieftain in FS Economy. That's why it's still at 5 passengers. But the Chieftain in real life, I think it's like 10 passengers.
Oh, okay.
It's basically running off the Navajo model for FSE, though.
As far as I know, I see. John, are the car models better in X-Plane than in?
Sterile cockpit, please. Rob can answer that question as I land. Are you talking about the car animations at the airports, etc.?
No, the actual roads.
Oh, the roads. Yeah, they're much better because the lights actually work. Or do they? I don't know. I haven't flown P3D for a while, but I would say the a lot of the card. Sorry about that, folks. Didn't mean to do that. I haven't flown the other sim for a while, so I really can't compare. Who out there can compare the two? All right, 188 feet per minute. That could have been better, but it's okay. Let's clear the runway. Palomar Tower, 572 Kilo Juliet. It's clear of 24 Alpha 4. Request taxi to below the tower for a plate of cookies.
For 572 Kilo Juliet, enjoy the cookies. Taxi to parking via Alpha.
To parking via Alpha, 572 Kilo Juliet.
Got to remember, you're landing kind of light there since you left your passengers.
That's no lie, sir. I've done that a few times. It's really annoying. But the good thing about it is I can go repeat the flight, right? Because they're still waiting. Okay, we're going to deliver our plate of chocolate chip cookies to the tower controller here for giving us fine service today. We're going to avoid that building over there because that's customs, I believe. So we'll just park over here by Zitawa.
Was that plate of cookies intended for the passengers that you didn't bring?
Yes. Decided to give them the tower controller instead. Let's disconnect from Pilot Edge before we do this replay. How does that sound? Disconnected. Oops.
Yeah. You're muted. I'm not. So everybody's watching the stream saying, why is Rob talking to himself?
Okay, I'm back here. Yeah, do I like the Beechcraft B-58 or the Piper Navajo better? I like the Navajo better, but mostly because I haven't flown the Baron that much. Although the Baron does have shared cockpit, so I did a shared cockpit flight in the Baron. So, Jay Green 821, see ya. Oh, FSX Grew, thank you.
Since I moved to New Jersey, I left the airline. I was a little fat at.
J-Snap, do you see that up above there? I'm trying to grab it. Hello, 1-2. All right.
Ooh, 15 more buildings to model.
There you go, FS Guru 15. Awesome. I just sent you. I sent you the link there, JSnap, and it's above. It's above there, so. And Uni is getting some information from X-Plane. So here's my landing at Palomar, coming in on 2-4. Information from X-Plane. So here's my landing at Palomar, coming in on 2-4.
sorry. No problem, that would be confusing. November 90875, make straight in runway 27, runway 27, clear to land.
Okay, runway 27, straight in, and clear to land. Minus 75.
Thank you, Don, for fly for the host there. Yeah, he's headed west.
Tower,